Hallelujah.
It's so good to be here. You know, I went back to our room this afternoon. I didn't sleep at all last night. I didn't sleep at all. And I didn't sleep much today. But I'll tell you something. The Spirit of God is really beginning to flood and to fill the body of Christ.
Yes.
And I am so thankful to be here with you, but to be in what God is doing in this time, in this hour. Like Brother Mark shared this morning, you know, we've been going for a long time and God's had certain things, but you know, this year the Lord spoke to me just as we're returning this year, and he said, this year is the year of a potential, you hear the word, potential, acceleration of my glory.
Yeah.
In the church.
Right.
And in that glory is all that he has for us, all that he desires to transmit and translate into our hearts, yes, into our lives, and through our lives.
Yes.
And I have been sharing for the last few weeks, or maybe even months, in our church in Oregon, on always advancing. And you know, the Lord wants us to go on to perfection.
Amen.
One of the things that began to trouble me after a number of years in ministry, that I saw a lot of God's people that were not growing.
Yeah.
Help me somebody.
Yeah.
They were not growing. And it troubled me. And the Lord wants us to grow up into him, praise God. He wants us to, the Bible said, he gave the apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, teacher, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come into the oneness of the faith,
yes,
to the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect man, to the measure of the stature,
yes,
of the fullness,
oh,
of
Lord,
Christ.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That's where we're headed. But I sense, as never before, I've shared this with a few folks, but I've sensed never before, this fullness is coming. I'm not going to come. It's coming right now.
Yes.
And if we will embrace that grace and that glory, there's transformation like this world has never seen that's coming into the body of Christ.
Amen.
And you know, the Lord told Joshua, every place that the foot of your soul shall tread upon, that have I given you. And you know, in order for them to keep on possessing, they had to keep on progressing.
Yeah.
He said, in order for them to keep on possessing, they had to keep on progressing.
Yeah.
And sometimes we can get into these situations or states in our heart and mind where we kind of get in a, you know, like we're idling. We're not going forward. We're really not going backward. We're just not moving onward. But this is a year of acceleration, of maturation, of maturity, of the outpouring of the Spirit of God. And advance for the children of Israel, in order for them to advance, they had to overcome all of the various limitations and restrictions and restraints that seemed to be imposed upon them when they were in the land of Egypt. Did you know that when they were in the land of Egypt, that they already had an inheritance?
Yes.
They already had an inheritance.
Right.
It already belonged to them.
Right.
It was given to them.
Amen.
They already had all that, it was already theirs.
Yes,
and yet they were being restricted and restrained and held in the land of Egypt, in the land of bondage.
Yep. Amen.
And, you know, if they were like us, I'm certain they wanted to come out of that place.
Yes.
You know, I was raised in a middle class home. My dad was a hard worker. And, you know, I never really wanted to be in poverty. I never really wanted to lack, and especially when we began to have children, I wanted to be able to buy shoes for our daughter.
Yeah.
Amen. That's right.
That was a nice idea.
Yeah.
Nice concept. But I wanted to have provisions. I don't want to live in poverty. I don't want to live in lack. I don't want to live in insufficiency. Not just financial insufficiency, but a lack of wisdom, a lack of understanding, a lack of joy, a lack of peace, a lack of righteousness. I want to live in the abundant life that has been bought and paid for through the shed blood of Jesus Christ. How about you?
Yes.
Now, in order for you and I to come into all that we have, we have to be able to come out of those positions of restriction.
Amen.
And restraint into the good land.
Yes.
And you know, it's interesting, you know, when you think, well, why didn't God just do it right there in the land of Egypt? He wanted to reposition them, not only in position, but also in condition.
Amen.
And sometimes the condition is not what is out here, but in what is in here. And sometimes we're like the 10 spies. We see ourselves as grasshoppers. We've got a grasshopper mentality. We've got a slave mentality.
Yeah.
We've got a inability mentality.
Yes.
And yet our God is a God of greatness, and all that he is and all he has already belongs to us.
Yeah, yeah.
You know that everything he has already belongs to us.
Yes.
So why are we possessing it? Because if you're going to possess it, you got to step in and take it, praise God. And it's in his grace and it's in his glory. Well, the Lord showed me that there are gateways and doorways that he himself will make for us. Not only to bring us in, but also to bring us out.
Yeah.
And there are a lot of people, maybe here today, there are people that are being held in positions and conditions. They're enslaved in their heart. They're enslaved in their mind. They can't see themselves as God sees us.
Yeah. Amen.
They can't see themselves. They don't even have a concept of who and what God desires for our life.
Right.
But the Lord wants us to reposition our hearts and our minds so that he can transform and translate us into his image, into his glory, into his majesty, into his goodness, praise God.
Amen.
Because our inheritance is in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
And that inheritance is in the glory of God.
Amen.
In the radiant splendor of God Almighty shining into our heart. He made us able, or meet, to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light.
Amen.
My God is able to supply all of your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. So all that he has and all that he is can be appropriated by you and appropriated by me by coming into that divine influence of his glory and grace. Not out here, but in here.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Transforming us and changing us. Well, you know, when the children of Israel were in the land of Egypt, they wanted to come out.
Yeah,
they
did.
They wanted to come out.
Yeah.
They probably didn't think that they could, but God came down.
Right.
Yeah.
And sent Moses into the land of Egypt with the rod of God in his hand, a type of the scepter of the kingdom of God. And with that scepter, God began to execute a force against the enemy, broke the enemy's stronghold off of the lives of the children of Israel, so that Pharaoh would let them go. But I believe he did something else at the same time. He not only broke something out there, he broke something in their hearts where finally they could see, you know, maybe we can be different.
Amen.
Maybe I don't have to live in slavery. Maybe I don't have to live in bondage. Maybe I don't have to be in sickness and disease all the days of my life.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. Maybe it can be different. Can you see it, my friend? Can you see that God has something awesome for us? And all he wants us to do is to step into his glory, step into our inheritance, step into that radiant splendor. That's where we are in terms of time. Praise God. Now, I noticed as I was researching through Scripture how many emphasis or how many times the terminology for gates, doors, were mentioned in Scripture. And it's interesting, you know, the Bible says to enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Hallelujah. How many know that there are gateways into the presence of God? Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Ezekiel said, the Spirit lifted me up and he brought me in by the door into the inner gate. You know the Holy Ghost can bring you into things that you can't bring yourself into. He'll bring you through doorways and gateways into the presence of God to transform your life, but not only for you, but that you can be an instrument of transformation out here in this world. How many of you know the world needs to see the church? I'm talking about churchianity, I'm talking about the glorious church rising up and shining out in the dark world.
Amen.
Right now.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Did you know he called us out of darkness into his marvelous light?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yep.
Into the freedom, the glorious liberty of the children of God, into freedom. And there are gateways and portals that the Lord has for you and I that he opens for us so that we can step out of what we were into what he is.
Amen.
We can step out of where we were into where he wants us to be.
Amen.
And I shared last night just briefly that the Lord spoke to my heart. And I'm telling you, this is not just a statement. This is a truth. The Lord is opening doorways right now.
Yep.
He's opening doorways, portals of not only of entering in, but portals of coming out.
Yes.
Get ready to come out of some things.
Come on, amen.
Amen.
And come into some things. And so the Lord is opening gateways. And we shared from the book of Revelation to the church of the Philadelphians, the Lord wrote and spoke, and he said, thus saith he that is holy, he that is true, he that has the key of David, he that opens and no man shuts, he that shuts and no man opens. Think about this for just a moment. The Lord can open doors for you that no one else can open.
That's right.
I said he can open doors for you that no one else can open.
Yes.
You can't open them.
Yes.
The Pope can't open them.
That's right.
Yes.
The President can't open them. But the Lord opens doors, praise God. And I want you to notice something. He said, behold. You know that word behold means to look.
Yeah.
Look. Yeah. I set before you an open door.
Amen.
And no man can shut it. Hallelujah.
Yes.
You know, that word man there is actually a Greek word that doesn't simply mean man. It could include woman, boy, or girl. But not just man, woman, boy, or girl, but it also could include demons and devils. And it actually means no one and no thing can shut the door that he opens for you.
Amen.
Behold, I set before you. Now think about this for a moment. I set before you is the Greek word in opion, and it means right before your presence, right in front of you, right in front of your face.
Hallelujah.
But you know, sometimes we think about the Lord, you know, doing this out here someplace, but he is actually the door himself.
Hallelujah.
And it's in his presence that the doorway opens for us.
Yes.
I want to show you this from a number of different scriptures. Hallelujah. Isn't he awesome?
Yes, he is.
Glory to God. I've got a list of verses here, just a few of the multitude that's in the scripture. But it says in Isaiah 45 and verse 1, thus saith the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden to subdue nations. Did you know that the church was created in the image? Well, you know, the man was created in the image and after the likeness of God. And God said, let them have dominion.
Yes.
He gave instruction to the children of to mankind, and he said, have dominion over the fish of the sea, the fowl of the air, over the beast of the field, and subdue it, multiply, increase. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Increase and subdue it.
Yep.
So again, he says, thus saith the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden, to subdue nations before him.
Yes.
In other words, the nations are going to fall before him. You know, the Lord told the children, I'm going to send the angel of my presence before you.
Yes.
He's going to drive out every enemy from before your face.
Yes.
No man will be able to stand before you. No devil, no demon, no giant Philistine, no walled city of Jericho. Nothing.
Yeah.
Will be able to stand before you because the angel of my presence is going to go before you and he is going to dispossess everything that is standing between you and your destiny.
Yeah.
Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Are you ready to enter into all that God has for you? I'll tell you, I am. I can bear witness with what Brother Meyer was sharing this morning about certain frustrations and various kinds of things. But the Lord spoke to me. He said, son, I'm not just opening for others a door. I'm opening for you a door, and you need to step through it.
Yes. Yeah. Amen.
You need to hear that. You need to step through it.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Yes.
Thus saith the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden to subdue nations before him. I will loose the loins of kings to open before him the two-leaved gates, and the gates shall not be shut. I will go before you and make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron.
Yes.
And I will give you the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of secret places, that you may know that I am the Lord which called thee by thy name. I am the God of Israel.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but he's not only the God of Israel, he's my God.
Yes.
I said, he's my God.
Yes.
He's the God that lives on the inside of me. He said, I'll walk in them and I'll dwell in them.
Yes.
And I will be to you a God, and you shall be to me a people. He lives in us, praise God.
Yes.
He lives in us. His life is in us. His life force is in us.
Yes. Yes.
Glory to God. Someone said, that's, are you excited? Yes.
Yeah, come on. It's true.
Well, notice this. He said, I'm going to go before you.
Yeah.
I'm going to go before you. It's his personal presence that eradicates and drives the enemy out from before your face, praise God.
Yeah.
And I saw an analogy one time about the Lord's presence driving the enemies out from before the face of the children of Israel. And you know, sometimes you and I are focused on how big our enemies are and this problem and this circumstance. But I'm going to tell you something. When you begin to look in his glorious face, everything else begins to fade
That's
away.
Right.
You don't see how big your enemy is. All you see is how awesome your God is.
Yes.
When you see how awesome your God is, everything else begins to dissolve.
Praise God.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. What an awesome God we serve.
Yes.
So his presence goes with. So there's an incident recorded in Scripture, very familiar one, but Jacob lays down, but in a certain place, he lays down, he puts some rocks there for a pillow. You know, I personally like a little softer pillows than that, but nevertheless, he made some rocks for his pillow.
That's right.
Yeah.
And he laid down, and he dreamed a dream. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord God said, I'll pour my Spirit out upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men, like Pastor Bob, will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams.
Amen.
Well, Jacob had a dream, and in this dream, he saw a ladder. And the ladder was set up on the earth.
Yes.
But its top reached up to heaven.
Yes.
And the Lord stood above it, and the angels of God.
Yes.
Where's Sister Ethel talking about the angel there? The angels of God were ascending and descending upon it. Did you know that all of the angels of God are ministering spirits sent forth to minister for you and I, who are heirs of salvation?
Yes.
Can I give you a testimony?
Go ahead.
I first started preaching. We'd gone over to one of our first meetings over on the Oregon coast. And I got my suit on, walking across. But here comes this German shepherd. Drooling. And he's running full speed.
Uh-oh.
And I said, stop in the name of Jesus. I mean, this is the absolute truth. That German shepherd hit the brakes. So we had a meeting. And after the meeting, this lady came up to me and she said, did you see that? I said, what? She said, when you were ministering, there were two huge, giant, warring angels standing, one on your right hand and one on your left.
Hallelujah.
I said, I didn't understand. And I thought it was interesting. You know, I thought it was an interesting concept.
Sure.
But then over the years, I've had a number of people that have come to me after that. So in one instance, we were having a service in our church, and the lady in the church called me the night before, Saturday night. And she said, oh, Pastor, I got something to tell you. I said, oh, what is it? She said, you think I should tell you?
Said,
yeah, tell me. And she said, well, you think I should? This went on for some time. Finally, I said, tell me. She said, well, my boyfriend has got a gun, and he's going to come to service tomorrow. He's going to kill you. I said, sure. And so, you know, I laughed like you did when she told me that. Until the next morning.
Hallelujah.
And they walked into service, and we would always sit over on the side, some, like you folks are doing. And all of the rest of the congregation was sitting this way, and this fellow was sitting on an aisle over here, and I had never seen him before, but I knew exactly who he was. You see, how do you know? Because he was sitting right next to her. Rocket science. So, and he had his arms like this, and he was locked in a gate. Everybody else was facing, you know, worshiping. He had his arms locked like this. And you know, when I first saw him, I know it wouldn't happen to any of you, but fear struck me.
Yeah.
So I just closed my eyes and I said, Father, I thank you that you've not given me the spirit of fear,
yes,
but of power,
yes,
and of love,
yes,
and of a sound mind.
Yes.
And every time I opened my eyes for about 20 minutes, this guy was locked in on me. And so sometime during that 20 minutes, I began to grow up in strength. Right? I began
Hallelujah.
And so when the service was turned over to me, he was sitting there, big guy, slightly larger than I, but he was a big guy. And so I walked over to him. I stood right off of his side. He turned around. I think he thought I was going to jump him or something. But just as that happened, there was a visiting evangelist, and he said, Pastor Bob, I got a word. And he came forward and he said, thus saith the Lord, there are two warring angels standing, one on your right hand and one on your left hand, and anyone that would set forth their hand to touch you will destroy you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know something? I hadn't told anybody. I hadn't told Laura about that lady called. The only people that knew about that was the lady, her boyfriend, and me. And so I'm telling you that the angels of God were sending and descending on the Son of Man.
Amen.
They were descending on, coming up and down on that ladder, and the Lord stood above it. And when Jacob awaked, he said, oh, truly the Lord is in this place. Truly the Lord is in this place. We were talking about the love of God. He that dwells in love dwells in God, and God dwells in him, because God is love. Truly the Lord is in this place. In other words, this is the place of his presence. This is the great place of his presentation. I was ministering to the Lord one time, and I said, Lord, I seek your presence. And the Lord said to me, yes, son, you're seeking the presentation of my person. That may not mean much to you, but it is to me.
Hallelujah.
In other words, that's where his person is presented. I know we're changed from glory to glory. We behold as in the mirror the glory of the Lord in the face of Jesus Christ. And so Jacob said, truly, surely the Lord is in this place, and I knew it not. He said, this is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven. And you know what? The Lord showed me that the place of his presence is the gateway.
Yes.
The place of his presence is the gateway. It's the portal into the heavenly realm where you can transition from all of his power, his grace, and his glory into your heart and into your life.
Amen. Yes.
Glory to God. In his presence. In his presence. Hallelujah. Yes. Jesus said in St. John chapter 10, verse 10, I am the door.
Amen.
I am the door.
Yes.
By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved, and he shall go in and out and find pasture.
Amen.
You know, sometimes the mindset of a lot of people is a Christ out here someplace. But my mindset is Christ in you,
Amen.
Christ in me, the hope of glory.
Amen.
And the one who's on the inside of us, the Christos, the Christ. Did you know he's the yoke destroyer and the heavy burden lifter?
Amen.
He breaks the rod. He breaks the chains of your enemy.
Yep.
He said, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor.
Amen.
He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted.
Amen.
Listen, to preach deliverance. Not just to preach it, but to bring it, to bring deliverance to the captive. What happens? There are folks that are being restricted, they're being restrained, they're being held by some force.
Yeah.
But when he comes on the scene, when the anointed one comes and his personal presence comes, he's a yoke destroyer.
Yes.
He's a rod breaker.
Yes.
He's a heavy burden lifter, praise God. We don't have to sit in bondage. We don't have to sit in slavery. We can come up and we can come out by his presence and his power and his glory, because he is the door.
Yes.
He is the gateway.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I'm the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved and go in and out and find pasture.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I want another good word.
Amen.
In Matthew chapter 16, Jesus was talking to his disciples. He said, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? And they said, some say that you're John the Baptist. Some say that you're Elijah or Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. And Jesus said, but who do you say that I am? And Peter said, you are the Christos. You are the Christ. You are the Messiah. You are the yoke destroyer. You're the heavy burden lifter.
Amen.
You are the Messiah. You are the Son of the living God. And Jesus said, you know what, Simon, you are blessed. Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah. You know how I like to define the word blessed? Empowered to prosper.
Yes,
you are blessed, Simon Bar-Jonah, because flesh and blood hath not revealed this to you. This didn't come from revelation. It didn't from man. This came by the revelation of the Father.
Amen.
Flesh and blood have not revealed this unto thee, but my Father who is in heaven, he hath revealed it unto you, and I say unto you that you are Peter, and upon this rock
Amen.
I will build my church.
Yes.
I will raise up my church.
Yes.
Help me, somebody.
Yes.
Raise up my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it.
That's right.
And if that's not enough for you, and I will give unto you.
Yes.
I will give unto you
yes.
the keys
Amen.
Of the kingdom
yes.
of heaven.
Yes.
So that whatever you bind on earth is going to be bound
yes.
in heaven. Whatever you restrain, whatever you restrict,
yes.
is going to be restricted.
Yes.
And whatever you loose.
That's right.
That's right. Hallelujah.
On earth is going to be loosed in heaven.
Amen.
Thank you. Now, once again, oftentimes we think, you know, Jesus comes up and I don't have any keys on me right now. But if I did, well, there we go. Ferrari, I'm like always. But if I did, you know, sometimes we think of this, you need a Ferrari.
Yeah, there you go.
But if I did, sometimes we think of it of this like this that Jesus said, oh, here.
Thank you, Lord.
It isn't like that at all. He gives us the key. As he revealed in us by the Father. In the very same way that a branch or a vine imparts to a branch the ability and the capacity to bring forth produce unto the image contained in the seed, he gives to us as he is revealed on the inside of us,
yes.
the Christ, the Messiah. He
yes.
gives us the keys.
Yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So that we don't have to be stayed in bondage. How many of you know he still wants us to rule
right.
and reign in the realm of life as
right.
priests and kings through one Christ? He wants us to rule and reign. He wants us to break every chain, to
yeah.
break every bondage.
Yeah.
We're not to be enslaved
That's
or being
right.
bound by demons and devils and
Amen.
Sickness and disease.
Yeah.
He wants the church to come up
yes.
and come up, praise God,
yes.
in him, by him, and through him,
right.
as he is revealed in us by his glorious majesty
Amen.
And power.
Yes.
He causes you and I to have the keys, the authority, and the dominion to execute and exercise that dominion.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm here to tell you tonight that the Lord is wanting to bring you up
yes.
and to bring you out and to bring you in, to bring
Amen.
You into
Amen.
New things, into new spaces and new places.
Yes.
And you know, sometimes we can get in situations and circumstances where we become comfortable.
Yeah.
Lord, can I say this to you? You know, you reminded me a lot of myself today as you were speaking in some way. But I'm going to tell you something. I really believe this, that you're coming out of some things and you're entering into some things.
Amen.
And it's not going to be an accident. It's because you are embracing
yeah.
the doorway.
Amen.
You're embracing the doorway.
Amen.
How are you willing to embrace the doorway that he
Amen.
Says before you?
Yeah.
You know, one of the things when we think about an open door actually means there's no restraint. There's no constriction. There's no restriction. You have freedom. You can step through. Now, you don't have to, but you can step through.
Amen.
And you know, sometimes there is another phrase for that is opportunity. You know, sometimes there are opportunities that are presented to us and we don't take advantage of it.
Amen. Come on. Yes.
And sometimes we don't realize, listen very carefully, some of you may be thinking, well, this doesn't appertain to me. I'm going to tell you it does appertain to you.
Yes.
Because there's, every one of us have an inheritance in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Every one of us have a destiny in God. God has purpose for your life and for my life.
Yes.
And it's high time, friends,
yes.
that the church arises
yes.
up in
yes.
the glorious majesty of the Lord, because the world needs to see the church
yes.
arise,
yes.
need to
yes.
flow and go in that which God is wanting to with you, because as we enter in, it not only brings us into a place, but it also brings us into a position to change cities, to change nations,
right.
And to change the world, praise
right.
God.
Right. Yes, amen.
You know, I'm reminded of Abram.
That's right.
Abram was in Ur of the Chaldees. And I've read that the Chaldeans were very adulterous. That means they idolatrous. They were worshiping idols. And the Bible tells that they that worship idols worship devils.
Amen.
They were worshiping demons.
That's right, they were.
And so this is the environment he grew up in.
Yeah.
So the Lord appears to him and he shares with him the gospel, the good news, the glad tidings. And he said, I want you to come out.
Yeah.
I want you to come out from your father's house in the land of your nativity, from your brethren, into a land that I will show. And the Bible records that Abram came out. He didn't even know where he was going, but he knew that he had to get out of that place if he can step into the next place.
Yeah.
To step out of that position, if he's going to step into the next position. To step out of that condition, if he was going to step into the new condition.
Amen.
And the old condition where they were worshiping idols, the new condition, God said, I'm going to be a God to you.
Yes.
I'm going to be a God to you and to your seed, and in blessing, I'm going to bless you.
Yes.
And in multiply, I'm going to multiply your seed like the stars of the heaven and like the sand upon the seashore. And in your seed, all nations of the earth are going to be enriched. They're going to be blessed.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Can you envision that God wants to use you to bless?
Thank you, Father.
Yes.
Yes.
Other individuals, other cities, other places, other spaces, other people everywhere you go.
Amen.
Amen.
So Abram came out of that place.
Yes.
He came out of that position. He came out of that condition. And God began to function through his heart and through his life. So that, and the Lord told him that he said, your seed is going to possess the gates of their enemies.
That's right.
Yeah.
Amen.
Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Listen, my friend. Your adversary does not have a legal right to hold you.
Amen.
That's right. Amen.
Your adversary does not have a legal right to hold you.
Amen.
He will hold you if you don't know your inheritance, if you don't know how to come out, you don't know how to go in.
Yeah.
You know, when Solomon was ordained to be king in the stead of his father David, he had a dream, and in the dream the Lord appeared to him and says, ask what I shall give you. And Solomon said, you have made thy servant king instead of my father. He said, I'm but a child. I don't know how to come out.
Yeah.
And I don't know how to come in.
Yeah.
Right. You know, I believe personally that there are a lot of people that are in sickness and disease, and if they knew how, they'd come out.
Amen. It's true.
And I'm also convinced that there's people that are in oppression.
Amen.
And they knew how, they would come out.
Amen.
Of that place. And I've discovered something. We do have an adversary. He does want to try to hold us. He does want to try to restrain us. But if we understand where our victory is and where the gateway is and where the door is, the Lord sets before us an open door that we can go through. And if that He is that door, He'll bring us out of that bondage, out of that sickness, out of that slavery, out of that oppression, out of that poverty. You believe that
today? Amen.
Amen.
How many of you believe He wants to bring you out?
Amen.
Not just for your sake. Not just for your sake. But you can touch.
Amen.
Everywhere
Amen.
You go.
Yes.
Because of the magnificent splendor of God that's emanating and radiating.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Things are changing for you, John. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And Carrie. And Michael. And Monica. Things are changing for you.
Amen.
You know that word that I shared with the Lord said to me? He said, you need to step through that door. That's a word for you, John. It's a word for you, Carrie. Can you is that bear witness with
me? Yes, it does. Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
You know, you can have it open, but you have to step through it.
That's right.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Right.
And I'll tell you something. When the Lord His presence and his glory is manifest on the inside of us. He dissipates every bondage, everything that's held us. Think about the church. Think about it. I'm going to give you 5 more minutes. Okay. Yeah, for old wine, new wine. Glory to God. You know, the children of Israel were enslaved. They were brought once again, even though they'd come out of Egypt. You know, when Lazarus was brought out of that grave, brought out of death into life, he was still bound. I said he was still bound. Jesus said, loose him and let him go. The children of Israel, even though they had come out of Egypt, they became ensnared again, and they were brought into bondage in Babylon. And you know, an interesting truth is Babylon means confusion. And I know no one in here tonight is confused. Confusion is a state of admixture of two opposites so that you can no longer distinguish one from the other. And when a state of confusion comes, as it was with the people there, they left off building and they were scattered. That's what happens when you're in confusion. But the Lord said that after 70 years you're accomplished in Babylon, I'm going to visit you and I'm going to perform my good word towards you.
Amen.
I'm going to perform my good word towards you. I'm going to perform my good word towards you.
Yes.
I'm going to perform my good word towards you.
Amen.
I'm going to bring you out of this condition, of this position. For I know the plans that I have for you. They're not plans to demote you. They're plans to promote you. They're plans to prosper you. Glory to God. Not just prosper you financially, but prosper you in that which God has ordained and destined for your life. To prosper you, not to harm you. To give you a future and a hope. To give you an expectation, praise God.
Praise the Lord.
To give you an expectation. Maybe it can be different. Maybe I can walk in victory. Maybe I can have fulfillment.
Amen.
And you know, the Lord goes on to say in that passage of Scripture, you shall seek me.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
You shall seek me. Say it with me, please.
You shall seek me.
One more time.
You shall seek me.
And you shall find me. When you search for me with all of your heart. You know, I like to rephrase that just a little bit for my own understanding. You shall seek me, and you shall see me when you search for me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
With all of your heart.
Amen.
Yes.
And when you find me, I'm going to turn away your captivity.
Amen.
I'm going to turn away your captivity.
Amen.
I'm going to turn away everything that has restricted you and constricted you and restrained you and held you. I'm going to bring you out of this place into a new place, into a new space, into a new position, and into a new condition. Can you sense it, my friends, that that's what the Lord is wanting to do in the body of Christ in this time, in this hour?
Yes.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
I'll tell you something, not just this time and this hour, if you'll receive it.
Yes.
I said, if you'll receive
Amen.
It.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
He said, Pastor, I don't know how to come out. I don't know how to come here. I'm going to tell you something, the Lord will show you.
Yes, He will.
That's right. Amen.
He will reveal on the inside of you. This is the way. Walk in.
Yeah.
He'll make a way where there seems to be no way. He'll make a way through the sea, through the mighty waters, through the rivers. He'll make a way where it looks like there's absolutely no way that you can come out of this condition and this position that you have been in for so long. But He will make a way where there seems to be no way.
Yes.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Now you need to come up higher in the Lord. I'm going to want to step into it.
Amen.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
You know, you can't just keep embracing what you have been and fully embrace what your destiny is.
That's right, amen.
That's good.
Amen.
We can't keep replaying over and over and over and over and over again what we were, that we want to come yet.
Come on.
He has destined us to be.
Yes.
Oh. Lady in our church, over and over and over and over again, I talked to her, look, you're transformed by the renovation, by the renewing of your mind. Stop rehearsing the past. You know, the Bible tells us to put off, don't put new wine into old. The Bible tells us to put off the old man.
That's right.
And to put on the new man, which after God has created in righteousness and in true holiness.
Yep.
Yes. Hallelujah. So a new door, a new space, and a new place.
Yes.
And I'm here to tell you tonight, since this last night, it was interesting because I wanted to share on something else in these meetings, and the Lord kept bringing me back to the gateways and doorways. Because, and then when I heard the messages last night, the words that were spoken last night, and what Brother Marsh shared this morning, I recognized that this was exactly what the Lord wanted for you and I to hear.
Amen.
And the truth is that the Lord opens, He set the door before you if you'll look.
Yes.
Amen.
If you'll look.
That's right. Look at Him.
If you'll look at Him, if you'll seek Him, you're going to discover this is the way.
Yep. Amen.
You're going to see it.
Amen.
And then you need to step into it.
Amen.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
Glory to God. You know, they sang that song tonight, Break Every Chain.
Yeah.
You know, there are a lot of chains that are holding individuals. Some are of our own making. Some are of our own mindset, our attitudes.
Amen.
Sometimes we become passive. I like what Brother Mark said today. He said, I told the Lord, I want to preach till the day I die. Not giving up, not quitting, not turning back.
Amen.
How many are not turning back?
Amen.
This is the most glorious time. This is the most glorious hour that any of us could have ever walked in.
Absolutely.
And I want you to embrace this tonight, because I'll tell you the truth. What I'm sharing with you tonight is not just another message. It's not just another message.
Amen.
Right.
You know, God can give you opportunities, but if you pass by the opportunity,
right.
Man,
you'll never have it. I agree.
You understand what we're saying
here?
Yes,
God
can open doors. He can give opportunities to us, but we need to be able to embrace it.
Amen.
Amen.
How many of you are ready to embrace that which
Amen.
God has for you?
Amen.
See, God's not a respecter of persons. He knows everything about you. He knows everything He's ordained. He said, I know the plans that I have for you. His plans may be somewhat different for you than they are for me or someone else, but He knows exactly what the plan is that He has for your life. He knows your destiny. He knows what He's ordained for you. And I'm telling you the truth, my friends. God is committed to your victory. He's committed to bring you all the way into the full position and full possession of that which He has ordained for you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
God. God is a good God.
He certainly is.
He's a great God.
Yes, He
is.
You shall seek me, and you shall find me.
Amen.
You know, one of the greatest things that I've ever learned is worshiping the Lord and seeking Him with my whole heart. And you know what I'm discovering? Not out here, but on the inside of him, discovering this majesty, this great God, this God who is light rising up on the inside. And this is the hour, this is the time for the body of Christ to embrace all that He is and all
Amen.
That He has.
Yeah.
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 Hallelujah.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Glory to God. It's only 10:30. We've got plenty more time.
Amen. Hallelujah. Lots of doors. Three, four.
The doors were open. The chains are locked. Break every chain. The open doors.
Amen.
God said, Lord said, I'm going to open doors that no man can shut. And I'm going to shut doors that no man can open.
Amen.
I'll tell you something. Some of you need some doors shut in your life.
Yes.
Some of you just need to shut the door.
Amen.
You can slam it if you want to, but just,
amen.
Just shut the door on your past.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
Because God's got a future.
That's right.
And a hope for you.
That's right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Would you stand with me, pray? Glory to God. This isn't the way that, that I've shared this message before, but it's the way that the Lord wanted me to share it tonight. Because we need to understand that this door is not out here. It's in here. And once you can vision it on the inside of you, you can step through. Once you can see, you can step through. I'm here ready for an open door.
Amen.
I'm here ready to step through. How many of you are courageous enough? How about the thought about Abraham? How much courage did it take for him to step out of? Come on. How much courage did it take for him to step out of all that he had known? Of all that he had lived? How many of you are courageous enough?
Yes.
To be as Peter, get out of the comfort zone of the boat and step out into the new things of God.
Amen.
Amen.
I'd like you to come forward right now, if you would, please.